This is a half-drawn environment running on a browser. As I move the slider, the angular position or the attitude of the drone follows the slider input. This is a basic drone control algorithm that you should know. Have you wondered how drones stay balanced in the middle of the air? It is done by a control algorithm called PID, which stands for Proportional Integral Drive. The PID controller is the simplest and the most common type of the control algorithm in robotics. However, when I was in the control class in my engineering school, I was bombarded with more than enough math for this simple PID control algorithm. I wanted to build a drone, but I was able to solve only math problems by the end of the semester. So I taught myself. Then I realized that the PID algorithm is very simple to understand and implement by yourself. So you don't really need any fancy math to understand the PID algorithm. Let me show you how. First, let's observe the scene to understand what problem we want to solve. Any flying objects in the 3D space not only need to maintain its altitude, but also its attitude. Yes, you heard me right, the attitude. In engineering, the word attitude means the orientation. Probably this may be coming from the disposition of orientation or something. But as is normal for engineers to be confused with the human languages, let's just move on with a smile. For a drone to be able to take off, it needs to be able to balance in the middle of the air first. So we need an attitude control algorithm. I know, it's kind of weird. How would you know if it balances in the middle of air even before taking off? Typically, for larger drones, I hook it up on a stand like this or this to test my attitude control. In practice, it has X, Y, and Z axis to balance, and we test for each axis at a time. And once you understand how the first axis works, the rest will be simple repetitions. Now, in this half-drawn environment, it has only one axis to control. On the top left, there is a panel showing current angle and the angular velocity. You can nudge it to CW or clockwise direction and CCW or counterclockwise direction, or you can simply pause the game if you want. On the bottom, you can adjust the PWM of each motor. For now, you can regard the PWM as RPM of the motor, or use the throttle to increase the both. On the right, you can turn on and off the PID controller. As its name indicates, we can adjust the amount of the proportional derivative and integral gains. The gain is just a constant to represent the sensitivity. Then there's a set point, which will be our desired angle for this drone to follow. Finally, there are the two most important indicators, error and the error integral. The error is simply calculated by subtracting the current angle by the set point angle. And guess what? The error integral is the sum of the error as the time goes. It is important to make sure that we threshold this error integral, like you can set the value bounded by negative 100 to 100. Now, let's try to play this drone manually first for some of you who may think they can control it by hands. First, I will increase the right side motor, and then try to control the left one manually. It's quite difficult to balance horizontally, for me at least. You can try this by yourself. I put my website link down in the description section. Sign up for free and play with it. First, let's turn on the controller. By default, it will sync the left and right motors with the throttle. So let's increase the throttle. Now let's see the error. It has the value, which is the current angle minus set point. Intuitively, we can think if we increase one of these motors, it will balance. So let's do that. I will simply increase the proportional gain. This value is multiplied to the error. Then the result value will be added to the motor output to increase one motor's output while decreasing another. That's the proportional control. Now, as you can see, after increasing the proportional gain, the drone is simply oscillating back and forth. That's because when the drone is at zero angle, the rotation speed is at the maximum. It's like when you drive a car, you can always step on the gas pedal proportional to the remaining distance, but you never stepped on the brake pedal. Then you pass the target point and do all the same again towards the opposite direction. So we need a brake system. The brake system in this context is like a derivative gain. The derivative of the position is the speed. So we need to break the system based on the speed or the error derivative. By now, you might be wondering why there's no indicator of the error derivative. Well, the error was defined like this. And then take the derivative. It will be simply a minus of the velocity. So by increasing the D gain, the controller will minus the motor output as much as angular velocity times the D gain. Then the system will immediately lower down its angular velocity towards the desired value. Now let me change the set point. The drone follows the input. You've just implemented a PID controller for drone attitude control. Next, if you are wondering, the integrated error is not zero, fantastic. As long as the error is zero enough, we don't care about yet. I'll see you in the next video. Well, I was just joking. Let's make a situation where this error integral comes useful. I will set up the length of one of the arms to 1 meter. Obviously, the drone is unbalanced. The previous PD controller cannot handle this anymore because its assumption is a perfectly balanced system. In practice, the unbalanced effect can happen all the time due to many factors like mounting location of your payload, like batteries, or dimension of your system itself, and literally anything. To compensate this unbalance, we need this error integral. By the way, if you wonder why don't we increase the proportional gain, please try to increase the proportional gain by yourself and comment below about what you have observed. Now, I will increase the integral gain, Ki. Then, this number is multiplied to the integrated error and added to the motor output. Then, the controller can compensate the system as much as the integrated error. Indeed, there are many more cases to observe by adjusting the PID gains with any numbers. I recommend you try and observe how it behaves. If you have any questions, comment down below. In the next video, I'll go over how to control this in Python. If you found this content helpful, hit the like button. Your support means really a lot to me. Also, I plan to keep posting the video like this, so stay tuned by subscribing my channel. We'll all deserve to learn in the most simplest way. I'll see you in the next video.